But we begin today with Sherry Ellison with Senior Helpers. We're going to talk more about her business, and we're going to speak about Parkinson's disease in general. So welcome.
Thank you.
Yeah. Tell us a little bit about your business. How does it work? Because it's important for folks to know if you have someone at home who needs help and maybe you need a break, Senior Helpers is there to help you out.
That's correct. We cover West Jacksonville, Duval area, Clay, St. John's, Baker, and Nassau counties.
Okay.
We come in the homes generally, but not necessarily. Wherever the senior lives and needs help, that's where we will go.
Okay, so let's say somebody just needs a break. Maybe they're taking care of an elderly parent or something, and they don't need somebody to be there 8 hours a day. What hours can you come and maybe just give the caretaker a break?
We have no minimum hours.
Okay.
If you need a shower visit and it's 1 hour, we will come in for a 1 hour shower visit. We do up to 24/7, and we also do live-in services.
Wow.
We're one of the last companies that actually do live-in service.
Okay. So do you guys, now all of the people that work for you,
are my employees.
Okay. All of them have been background checked?
FBI fingerprinted, background checked. We do criminal background checks. We do checking on their driver's license because they will provide transportation as well.
Okay.
We also do drug testing arbitrarily.
Okay, and that's important. Why is that so important in this day and age? Is it because so many of the homes that they go into, a lot of the people that they're caring for, I would assume, have access to narcotic medications and it's right there at the
home? Yes, it is. Yes. So we oversee that process and make sure that either the medications are taken out of the home or they're controlled by a family member or one person in our group is in charge of it all.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. What types of care do you do the most, would you say?
Personal care, Alzheimer's care, needing bathing and dressing and walking assistance and transportation needs. It runs the whole gamut, and it runs from all the gamut of times also.
Okay, all right. What are you guys finding with Parkinson's? What's the latest on that? Because I know you're really, clued into that and piped into all of the new research.
We are all trained in Parkinson's as well because we have to know what stage a person is in Parkinson's, what their particular affiliation is, because they may just have rigidity or they may have the shakes, and what can we do about it? Mm-hmm. Do we need to give a different kind of spoon for them to use so that they don't shake their food off their spoon? Do they need help with walking? Mm-hmm. What can we do? We can get a laser light, put it in front of them, and it will help them walk. We can put tape on the floor, and as long as our caregivers know what to do at any one time, we're able to help them prolong their life at home and enjoy their life.
I think a lot of times they have just difficulty dressing themselves.
They may not.
or they may not. I guess it all is a case-by-case basis.
Case by case.
Mm-hmm. When people get Parkinson's disease, it seems like they can lose a lot of weight. And I don't know if that is directly related to the shaking and the burning of the calories because they're in constant movement of some sort, even when they're still oftentimes.
Mm-hmm. Well, it depends on what kind of Parkinson's they do have, too.
Okay.
But a lot of it's just because of aging in place, and they just don't have the feeling and taste of wanting to eat. Also, one of the interesting things I learned when I was learning Parkinson's is that 10 years before you're actually diagnosed with Parkinson's, you can lose the sense of smell. So if you don't have your sense of smell, nothing tastes good because you don't smell it.
It could be a precursor then.
It is a precursor.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Mm-hmm. All right. And what did you bring along with you?
Today I brought a will about Parkinson's. And what it does is it tells you on one side the motor symptoms that go along with each one of the different Parkinson's symptoms, such as if you have freezing of gait, meaning that you freeze when you're talking or attempting to walk.
Let's hold it up to the camera so folks turn around.
And it'll tell you the strategies and techniques to use if you are freezing of gait, such as holding a laser light in front of them, because it is a neurological issue.
Okay.
Parkinson's is neurological.
So this is kind of nice because it's understanding and non-motor symptoms. Mm-hmm. And as you can see, we can get one of these wheels, I hope, from you guys.
Yes, yes.
What else does it say on there?
It also has on the back side anxiety that may go along with it. You may have hallucinations. There is dementia that can go along with Parkinson's as well. And it goes through every single thing of the characteristics and strategies to help that person with whatever they are facing.
Okay.
Now, I will gladly give these out. Mm-hmm. If you call our office at 904-779-5515, 904-779-5515. Schedule an appointment with me. I will come out, give you do a free assessment for your mom or dad or yourself, mm-hmm. and give you a will for you can understand how Parkinson's works.
Yeah, no, that's really good. And I have seen, I guess it's the big pharma commercials that show like a gentleman that has Parkinson's and then it shows those hallucinations. Mm-hmm. We've all probably seen that commercial. So that's part and parcel with Parkinson's. Does that usually come on in the later stages?
It all depends. Some people do not get hallucinations at all and some start out with hallucinations.
Oh my.
Yes, it all depends on where your Parkinson's particular is placed.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, give her a call. She can give you a wheel. And then if you just need some help with a parent or you need a break, if you're a caretaker, these guys can
you
come
will
out.
Need a break.
That's right.
It's very, very hard and difficult to take care of a Parkinson's person. But the biggest thing you can do is keep them active, mm-hmm. get them involved, get them to do things that they like to do. Kickboxing is one of the best things you can do for a Parkinson's person. Mm. So, and there are kickboxing classes around that are built for Parkinson's in this area.
Wow, that's mm-hmm. great to know. Mm-hmm. All right, well, listen, Sherry Ellison with Senior Helper, thank you so much for coming
thank
on.
Thank you. Thank you, Karen.
Okay. Up next, you'll hear from the owner of the best remodeling company around. That's right, Tony Davis with Granite Transformations is on deck. Stay with us. Mm-hmm.